Jets. as a backup keeper. I'm told it is on Dean Smith's list of transfers this summer. But at this point, there's not really any targets floating about. Now, for me, I would be maybe looking at somebody from the Championship, because, you know, they're not looking at bringing in somebody to challenge Martinez at this point. He is absolute outright number one. They're looking, though, at somebody who is, if he gets injured, who can confidently step in. Jedstay is probably not good enough for that, from my perspective anyway. So maybe somebody like David Raya from Brentford, or Senny Dieng from QPR. Both had really good seasons in the Championship last year. I think you could get either of them for less than 10 mil. I think that would be really, really astute signings for Villa, and just kind of shore up that position. Centre backs, then, they've got Ezri Konsa, Tyrone Mings, and Courtney House. After they've let Engels go, that's all they've got. They've just got three centre backs now, which is interesting. You know, I'm assuming that they will definitely look to bring in a centre back there for. But yeah. Konsa, sort of top 25 to top 30 centre backs in the league last year. Mings, sort of top 25. This is sort of statistically, obviously Mings did all right in the Euros, to be fair to him, did pretty good. Yeah, you know, they're decent Premier League standard. As a starting centre back partnership, I think that Dean Smith has a lot of faith in Konsa and Mings, and I think there's a hope that they will improve together. I don't think that's European football standard, though. I really don't. Konsa and Mings, I think one of them with somebody better than them potentially could be. But yeah, you know, they're competent for sure. They're decent. But you know, top 25 in the league, what does that place you in? If there's two centre backs per team, yeah, that's pretty much a mid-table team then, isn't it? Mid-table team. House did all right when he's come in, to be fair. Not played a lot of games, but he was pretty decent when he's come in. But I think they need to bring somebody in there. They're linked with Twan Zabi. Obviously, it was really good for them in the Championship on loan. Linked with Twan Zabi. Does Twan Zabi improve that centre-back partnership? I don't really know if he does. Not played a lot of football the last couple of years, but yeah, I mean, I'm a Man United fan. A lot of Man United fans rave about Twan Zabi. I'm not altogether that convinced myself, but you know, you never know. They might get Twan Zabi, and he might really be an improvement for them. So could be a good caliber signing. I don't know whether that'd be on loan or a purchase. But he has signed a new deal for United, so I wouldn't be surprised if we sold him. What the fee would there be there, I don't know. Maybe you'd be looking in the 15 to 20 mil range. I wouldn't be mad at that, and I wouldn't say that that's a bad bit of business for Villa either. So maybe they'll look to do that this summer. But they certainly need another centre back, because they've only got three at the minute. Right backs, they've got Matty Cash, who was a revelation for them from Forest, top 10 right back. They've got Gilbert at the minute. Now they've brought him back in from loan. They've let El Mahmoudi go. I don't really know whether they're looking to keep him as backup for Cash, or whether they'll be looking to loan him out again or sell him. They've got Ashley Young now. Whether they look at him being backup. But yeah, that's where they're at. But Matty Cash is certainly competent. They have currently got backup in there. Not an area that they need to strengthen at the minute. Left back, Matt Target, again, really, really good signing for them. Top 10 left back in the year. And again, they've got Ashley Young, who I think is probably their primary left back backup, who's experienced, so fair dues. The kind of DM / centre mid roles, because again, Villa are a team that play with primarily kind of two sixes / eights, two holding players. They've got Douglas Luiz, John McGinn, Conor Harian, Marvellous Nakamba, and Sanson from Marseille, came in January and then unfortunately got injured by April. So Douglas Luiz was about a top 25 midfielder last year. McGinn was about a top 15 Smith Rowe so far. That deal seems to be dead in the water now. I'm not really sure who they will look to go in for now instead, but it definitely seems to be an area that they would like to kind of strengthen. So yeah, that'll be an interesting one for sure to see who they go in for now that Smith Rowe seems to not be happening. But again, for the types of players that they're looking for, they're looking at spending quite a bit of money there. Definitely seems to be a priority though. I'm just trying to think who would I think of that they could go for. Villa. Not too sure, to be fair. It's for the calibre of the player that they're looking to bring in. You could be looking at a lot of money. Maybe somebody on loan again. They had Barkley on loan in that position last year. I don't think they'll look to go for Barkley again. Maybe they could get somebody on loan from the likes of Chelsea or somewhere like that who are maybe overly stacked in that position. Not sure. Interesting. Very interesting. Let me know who you think that Villa could go and try and get as a number 10, guys. Be really interested to see what people think, because it's a tough one. It's a really tough one. Because I think Buendia is, of course, coming in as their primary player on the right wing now. So, right wing there, they're stacked, really. They've got too many players, if anything, on the right wing. So they've got Buendia, who will be undoubtedly their number one Championship player of the year. They've got Traore, who obviously played there. El Ghazi, who played there. And Trezeguet can play there as well. I wonder if they will offload one of those players this year. Left wing, they've obviously got Grealish, who was statistically the best player in the league from the left last year. And Trezeguet probably his primary backup. Villa's best signing this year, undoubtedly, of course, will be keeping Jack Grealish. I think they will. I genuinely think that they will keep Grealish this year. I really, really do. If they don't keep Grealish, it's going to take, for me, at least 100 million. I cannot see him being sold for less than 100 mil. Now, if they get 100 mil, all bets are off. So all these things that I'm talking about now and their transfer plans change all of that, because they'll spend a shitload of money on different areas of the pitch, and I think they'll bring in a lot of good players. But yeah, I think Grealish will stay. Up top, they've got Watkins, who was, again, I thought when they went for him, I was saying that they should go for him before they did. Really, really great Watkins, and he had a great season last year. Top 10 striker in the league. They've got Wesley, obviously coming back from horrendous injury. And they've got Keenan Davis as kind of a young backup as well. There is talks that is a position that they're looking to strengthen in. There's obviously been a lot of talk of Tammy Abraham. Now, for me, if I'm Villa, I'm not spending 30, 40 million on Tammy Abraham. There's no way I'm doing that. Watkins, surely you're not looking to upgrade on Watkins already. And what they need is adequate backup for Watkins, really. That's what they want to be looking at. The real rumour that's having a lot of traction at the minute is Julian Alvarez, who's with River Plate. Now, again, he's primarily been a right winger in his career, but he also can play striker. I assume they're not looking at bringing in a fifth right winger, so that must be his backup for Watkins. He's got a 21 mil release clause. He's 21. That fits the profile for, you know, proper backup for Watkins, I would have thought, rather than, you know, coming in as a new starter. So yeah, if I was them, I wouldn't go for Tammy Abraham unless he's on loan and unless he is backup. And you know, Julian Alvarez, of course, he's young, he's from Argentina, it's a risk, but that fits the bill more for what they should be looking to do, I think. I think the primary ones for them, though, were, for me, centre-back.